With our report, the Federal Bureau of Investigations has joined a multi-agency investigation to further probe the murder of businessman Mohamed Bashir after his reported disappearance on May the 10th. Bashir's body was retrieved in Nyamindi River and was taken to Kerugoya Hospital Level 5, where police took his fingerprints to ascertain his identity. He had injuries on several parts of the head and as well as bullet wounds. Our reporter, Joy Motache, with more on that story.
River Nyamindi in Kirinyaga is a place that has been linked to many homicide cases, most recently the discovery of the 35-year-old Somali-American businessman Mohamed Bashir. 3 days after he was reported missing, his naked body washed up on Nyamindi's riverbed and was discovered by a local. Bashir's body was said to have severe injuries on the head and a broken neck as well. On the 22nd of May, his family members identified his body at the Kerugoya Level 5 Hospital almost a week after it was recovered from the river. The autopsy of Mohamed Bashir will be carried out today to determine the exact cause that led to the death of the young businessman. Who wanted Mohamed Bashir Mohamed dead and why? The who and why in this particular case is still unclear for now, but a look at the circumstances before his disappearance in Kilimani display conventional behavior and movement from Bashir in the CCTV footage reviewed at Miale Lounge. The footage shows him arriving at Miale at 5:23 p.m. as he tipped security guards and bouncers at the premise. The footage then shows him departing from the lounge at 6:50 p.m., indicating the last time he was seen before the finding of his body in River Nyamindi. Days after, his family members recorded a missing persons report at Muthangari Police Station. Family members requested the tracking information from the tracking device in his vehicle. When the information could not be found by the company that installed the device, his lawyer, Ali Bahi Hassan, said, tracking device may have been disabled by the perpetrators. The Range Rover was later found burned down to its shell and deserted in Kibiku area in Ngong, Kajiado County. Further claims insist that Bashir may have been connected to the current political strife in Somalia and that he allegedly used fake currency during his trading agreements to fund terrorist activities. His family mentioned that they have a reason to assume that Bashir was arrested by police following a habeas corpus application handed in at the Kajiado Law Courts. However, his family and his lawyer, Al-Bahi Hassan, insist that he was a straightforward, amiable man. Bashir was a construction engineer and the director of Infinity Developers, which has been working on various construction projects, including one in Lavington, the Uhuru Project in Kisumu, and the Kibuya Market in Kisumu. A promising and ambitious young man, Bashir had American citizenship and resided in Ohio, United States, and moved to Kenya 5 years ago to undertake partnerships and construction projects in the country. As he leaves behind his wife and newborn child, the investigation continues in search of answers for the untimely demise of Mohamed Bashir Mohamed. Joy Muchache, Look Up TV, Nairobi.
Thank you.